students. So yesterday I have seen so problems on matrix multiplication. So today we will start the new concept in matrices. So that is transpose of a matrix. See. Transpose of a matrix. So what is the meaning of transpose? See. So transpose of a matrix is a matrix. Transpose of a matrix is a matrix obtained by interchanging rows and columns. Interchanging rows and columns. Right? So transpose of a matrix is a matrix obtained by interchanging rows and columns. For example, see here. So if matrix A is 1, 3, 4, 5, minus 2, 5. Let us say this is matrix A. So transpose of a matrix is generally represented by A transpose. So what is A transpose? First row will become first column. Right? So first row will become first column. What is first row? It is 1, 3. So that will become first column. Right? So interchanging rows and columns means what? All rows will become columns. All columns will become rows. First row is 1, 3. So that will become first column. Second row is 4, 5. So that will become second column. So third row is minus 2, 5. So that will become third column. So what is the order of this matrix? 3 cross 2. What is the order of this matrix? 2 cross 3. In general, if matrix A is having order m cross n, so then A transpose is represented by A dash, and in some textbook it is represented by AT also, right? So if matrix A is having order m cross n, so then its transpose is having order, then its transpose is having order n cross m, right? So now see, so if A is 1, 3, 4, 5, minus 2, 5, its transpose is this. I will give one more example. That is matrix A, 1, 3, 10. Let us say if it is matrix A, then its transpose, it is a row matrix, its transpose, there is only one row, so that will become a column. So that is 1, 3, 10. A row matrix will become a column matrix after transpose. So order of this matrix is 1 cross 3. Order of this matrix is 3 cross 1. Similarly, if matrix A is 4, 5, 10, then its transpose. So A is a column matrix, so its transpose will become a row matrix. That is 4, 5, 10. Right? So what is the order of this matrix? This is 3 cross 1. So the order of this matrix is 1 cross 3. Right? So in general, if matrix A is having order m cross n, then its transpose will be having order n cross m. See students, next, properties of transpose of matrix, right? So we have some properties. So now we know what is transpose of matrix. Transpose of a matrix is a matrix obtained by interchanging rows and columns. That is, first row will become first column, second row will become second column, third row will become third column, right? So next we have some properties of transpose of matrix. See here. So properties of transpose of matrix. Properties of transpose of matrix. First property, that is transpose of A transpose, so that is matrix A itself. So that is first property. For example, see here, matrix A, so that is 1, 2, 4, 5, 3, 7. Right? So this is matrix A. Take transpose of this matrix. A transpose, what is A transpose? That first row will become first column. So what is first row? 1, 2. So that will become first column. So what is second row? 4, 5. So that will become second column. Right? So what is third row? 3, 7. So that will become third column. So again, take transpose of A transpose. What is the property? Transpose of A transpose is again matrix A. So again, take transpose of this. A transpose, whole transpose. Right? So A transpose, then A transpose is this matrix. So again, take transpose of this. Right? So again, take transpose of this. So what is first row? 1, 4, 3, so that will become first column. Right? So first row is 1, 4, 3, that will become first column. What is second row? 2, 5, 7, so that will become second column. Now we can observe, so that A transpose, O transpose is same as matrix A. So this is from first property, A transpose, O transpose is again a matrix A. Right? So this is matrix A, take transpose of this, again take transpose of A transpose. So finally we are getting a matrix which is nothing but matrix A. Right? So next, second property is K into matrix A whole transpose is equal to K into A transpose. Right? So where K is any constant. I will take some examples here. So let us say this is matrix A, it's 2, 1, 3, 5. Let us say this is matrix A, then I will take constant K, I will take dash 2. Now I will prove this. So what is left hand side? What is LHS? It is K into A whole transpose. Right? So K into A whole transpose. So that is K into A whole transpose. So first I will find K into A. See here. First I will find K into A. So what is K? It is 2 into matrix A. What is matrix A? 2, 1, 3, 5. That is applying a transpose to a constant doesn't make any difference. That constant will remain same. We are taking transpose only to a matrix. That is transpose of any constant number is again same that constant number. Right? So 2 into matrix A is 2, 1, 3, 5. So that is 2 into 2 is 4. Right? So 2 into 1 is 2. So 2 into 3 is 6. So 2 into 5 is 10. So this is K into A. But what we required is K into A whole transpose. That is LHS of that property is K into A whole transpose. Then take transpose of this matrix, that is K into A. So take transpose. First row is 4, 2. So that will become first column. Second row is 6, 10. So that will become second column. So this is the left hand side. What is right hand side? K into A transpose. See, RHS is K into A transpose. See, so K is how much it is? It's 2 into A transpose. Already this is matrix A. Take transpose of this. What is first row? 2, 1. So that will become first column. What is second row? 3, 5. So that will become second column. Therefore, RHS is equal to, so 2 into 2, 4, scalar multiplication of a matrix. So 2 into 2 is 4, 2 into 3 is 6, 2 into 1 is 2, 2 into 5 is 10. Now we can see LHS is 4, 6, 2, 10. What is RHS? That is also 4, 6, 2, 10. So that is LHS is equal to RHS. So that is K into A whole transpose is equal to K into A transpose. So which is the second property. Right? So then we'll see the third property. See. What is the third property? See. Third property A plus B whole transpose is equal to A transpose plus B transpose. Right? So I will let us take, I will take matrix A as 1, 5, minus 2, 3. Matrix B as 3, 1, 2, 7. Right? So first I will find what is left hand side is A plus B whole transpose. So first I will find A plus B. So that is A plus B, matrix A plus B, just add these two matrices. We know already how to add two matrices. First element is added with first element, 1 plus 3 is 4, 1 plus 3 is 4. Second element is added with second element, 5 plus 1 is 6. Right? So third element is added with the third element, minus 2 plus 2 is 0. Fourth element is added with fourth element, that is 3 plus 7 is 10. Next, I will find LHS. What is LHS? It is A plus B whole transpose. Then take transpose of this matrix. Right? So what is transpose of this? First row is 4, 6. So that will become first column. So again second row is 0, 10. So that will become second column. So this is the left hand side, that is A plus B whole transpose. Next I will find RHS. So what is RHS? That is A transpose plus B transpose. Right? So RHS is equal to A transpose. Take transpose of A. So matrix A is here, take transpose of this. So 1, 5 is first row, that will become first column. Second row is minus 2, 3, that will become second column. Plus B transpose. So matrix B is here. Take transpose of this. First row is 3, 1. So that will become first column. Second row is 2, 7. So that will become second column. Right. So then add these two matrices, RHS. So that is 1 plus 3. 1 plus 3. First element is added with first. 1 plus 3 is 4. Minus 2 plus 2. Minus 2 plus 2 is 0. 5 plus 1. 5 plus 1 is 6. Right. So third element. So then 3 plus 7. So that is 3 plus 7 is 10. Now we can see LHS and RHS both are same. 4, 0, 6, 10. So therefore, LHS is equal to RHS. So that is A plus B whole transpose is equal to A transpose plus B transpose. So this is the third property. So we have one more property, that is fourth property, that is A into B whole transpose is equal to B transpose into A transpose. We have problems on this property, so that I have solved. Now I can prove this property with one example in the next class, right? So AB whole transpose is equal to B transpose into A transpose. So these are the some properties, right? So these are the some properties of matrices. Now see, now I can prove this property by taking some examples, right? So now see, so it's definitely there is 3-mark question, sometimes there is 5-mark question on this property, that is AB transpose is equal to B transpose into A transpose. Many a time there will be 3-mark question or 5-mark question, right? So now I will prove, or we have some problems on that property. See here. If matrix A is equal to minus 2, 4, 5, matrix B is equal to 1, 3, minus 6, then prove that AB whole transpose is equal to B transpose into A transpose. This is the last property, and this is the problem on that property. See here. So first I have to find left hand side. What is left hand side? AB whole transpose. First I will find matrix AB. So what is matrix A? That is minus 2, 4, 5 into B. What is B? That is 1, 3, minus 6. Already I showed you how to multiply these two matrices. What is the order of this matrix? 3 cross 1. What is the order of this matrix? 1 cross 3. Now these two are same, right? So the resultant matrix is of order 3 cross 3. Resultant matrix is of order 3 cross 3. Now multiply this. Already we know that is first row into first column. So minus 2 into 1 is minus 2. Right. So first row into second column. Minus 2 into plus 3 is minus 6. First row into third column. Minus 2 into minus 6 is plus 1. Next second row into first column. 4 into 1 is 4. So second row into second column, 4 into 3 is 12. Second row into third column, 4 into minus 6 is minus 24. Next, third row into first column, 5 into 1 is 5. So third row into second column, 5 into 3 is 15. So next, third row into third column, 5 into minus 6 is minus 30. So this is AB, but we require to find AB transpose. LHS, what is LHS? AB transpose. Then take transpose of this. That is minus 2. First row is minus 2 minus 6, 12. That will become first column. Second row is 4, 12 minus 24. That will become second column. 4, 12 minus 24. 5, 15 minus 30. So that will become third column. So this is your left hand side. Next, RHS. What is RHS here? That is B transpose into A transpose, right? So RHS, first I will find B transpose. What is B transpose? What is matrix B? 1, 3, minus 6. So take transpose of this. That row matrix will become a column matrix. That is 1, 3, minus 6. Into A transpose. Matrix A is column matrix. That will become row matrix. That is minus 2, 4, 5. So what is the order of this matrix? 3 cross 1. What is the order of this matrix? 1 cross. Now we can multiply. What is the order of resultant matrix? 3 cross 3. So therefore, RHS is equal to, see, first row into first column. 1 into minus 2 is minus 2. First row into second column. 1 into 4 is 4. First row into third column. 1 into 5 is 5. Next, second row into first column, 3 into minus 2 is 6. Second row into second column, 3 into 4 is 12. Second row into third column, 3 into 5 is 15. Right, next, third row into first column, minus 6 into minus 2, that is plus 12. Minus 6 into plus 4, minus 24. Minus 6 into plus 5, that is minus 30. Now we can observe, left hand side first row is minus 2, 4, 5. Here also minus 2, 4, 5. Second row is minus 6, 12, 15. Here also it is minus 6, 12, 15. Third row is 12, minus 24, 30. Here also 12, minus 24, 30. So therefore, AB transpose is equal to B transpose into A transpose. This is the fourth property and this is an example on fourth property. See students, next we'll go for one more problem. Next, if matrix A is equal to 1, minus 4, 3, matrix B is equal to minus 1, 2, 1. So then prove that AB transpose is equal to, so this problem is asked for 5 marks in 2018 question paper, right? So first I will find left hand side. What is left hand side? A into B. First I will find what is left hand side, is AB transpose. In order to find AB transpose, first you have to find matrix AB. So that is A into B. So what is A? It is 1 minus 4, 3 into matrix B, that is minus 1, 2, 1. Right? So what is the order of this matrix? What is the order of this matrix? 3 cross 1. So there are 3 rows and 1 columns. So what is the order of this matrix? 1 cross 3. Now these two are same. Now we can multiply. What is the order of resultant matrix? That is 3 cross 3. Right? So first multiply. So already we know how to multiply this. So R1 into C1. First row into first column. Right? So that is 1 into minus 1 is minus 1. Next, first row into second column. That is 1 into 2 is 2. Right? So first row into third column. First row into third column. 1 into 1 is 1. Right? So next, come for second row. There is no fourth column. So then come for second row. Second row into first column. So minus 4 into minus 1, it is plus 4. Right? So second row into second column. Minus 4 into plus 2, that is minus 8. Next, second row into third column, minus 4 into plus 1 is minus 4 into plus 1 is minus 4. Next, third row, come for third row, as there is no fourth column, then come for third row. Third row into first column, so 3 into minus 1 is, 3 into minus 1 is minus 3. So 3 into 2, so that is third row into second column, 3 into 2 is, 3 into 2 is 6. Next, third row into third column, so that is 3 into 1 is. Now we got matrix AB. Next, find AB transpose. LHS. What is LHS? AB whole transpose is equal to, what is first row? Minus 1, 2, 1. That will become first column. Minus 1, 2, 1. What is second row? 4 minus 8 minus 4. That will become second column. 4 minus 8 minus 4. What is third column? Minus 3, 6, 3. That will become third column. Minus 3, 6, 3. So this is your left hand side. Next, we will find the right hand side. What is right hand side? B transpose into A transpose. First, I will find A transpose. What is A transpose? So that is column matrix. That will become row matrix 1 minus 4, 3. So then B transpose. What is B transpose? That row matrix will become column matrix minus 1, 2, 1. Right? So then find RHS. So what is RHS? What is RHS? That is B transpose into, what is RHS? That is B transpose into A transpose, right? So first write matrix B transpose. What is B transpose? That is minus 1, 2, 1. Right? So that is B transpose into A transpose. What is A transpose? That is 1 minus 4, 3. Right? So what is the order of this matrix? 3 cross 1. What is the order of this matrix? 1 cross 3. These two are same. Now we can multiply the matrices. What is the order of resultant matrix? That is 3 cross 3. Right? So RHS. So multiply first row into first column. First row into first column. Minus 1 into plus 1 is minus 1. So first row into second column. Minus 1 into minus 4 is plus 4. Minus into minus is plus. 1 into 4 is 4. First row into third column. That is minus 1 into plus 3 is minus 3. Right? So then come for second row. Second row into first column. So 2 into 1 is 2. Right? So second row into second column. 2 into minus 4 is minus 8. Second row into third column. So 2 into 3 is 6. Right? So then come for third row. Same. Third row into first column. Third row into first column. 1 into 1 is 1. Right? So third row into second column. 1 into minus 4 is minus 4. So third row into third column, 1 into 3 is 3. 1 into 3 is 3. So now we can observe. So this is, say it is 1 and it is 2. LHS, what is the first row? Minus 1, 4, minus 3. Here also minus 1, 4, minus 3. What is second row? 2, minus 8, 6. Here also it is 2, minus 8, 6. What is third row? 1, minus 4, 3. Here also it is 1, minus 4, 3. So therefore, from 1 and 2, I can write, so AB from 1 into I can write LHS is equal to RHS, that is AB whole transpose is equal to B transpose into A transpose, right? So this is the fourth property and problem on fourth property, right? So try to solve one problem on this, very similar, just try to solve. So that is if matrix A is equal to 0, 1, 2 and matrix B is equal to 1, 5, 7. So then prove that. So that is AB transpose is equal to B transpose into A transpose. Right? So just try to solve this problem. So today I will discuss properties of, that is transpose of matrix and properties of transpose of matrix. So on fourth property, we can expect one question which may be for 3 marks or sometimes it may be asking for 5 marks, right? So in the next class, we'll see the next concept, right? So that is in elementary operation, the inverse of a matrix by elementary operation, and we'll solve some more problems on this concept and we'll start the new concept, that is inverse of a matrix by elementary operation. Thank you, friends.